हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द साइंटिफिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू बाय जे बी एस हेल्डेन फ्रॉम प्रोज सेक्शन। J.B.S. Haldane was a great scientist. He took the citizenship of England later. J.B.S. Haldane studied at Oxford University, London. Then he became a professor at Cambridge University, London. He taught genetics there. One of his colleagues has commented about J.B.S. Haldane. He said, "It seems J.B.S. Haldane knew all that was to be known. This great scientist was born on November 5, 1892, and he breathed his last on December 1, 1964. J.B.S. Haldane was son of John Scott Haldane. His father was also a scientist. J.B.S. Haldane wrote many books. He wrote many essays. Most of his essays are on science and scientific topics. J.B.S. Haldane was deeply influenced by Marxism. He contributed articles to Marxist workers regularly. Later, J.B.S. Haldane became a professor at Indian a Statistical Institute, Kolkata. He also became a professor of California University, USA. The present essay, The Scientific Point of View, is extracted from his famous work Science and Ethics and Inequality of Man. After talking about the author, let me talk about the present essay, The Scientific Point of View. In this essay, J.B.S. Haldane talks about scientific standpoint. He emphatically stresses that scientific point of view is God's eye view. In the beginning of the essay, J.B.S. Haldane says that science has affected people in two ways. Number one, men, women have the application of science by traveling in train, omnibus, motors, instead of horse-driven vehicles. Getting themselves treated by a doctor or surgeon instead of going to a witch. Being killed by automatic pistol, shell, bomb instead of dagger and axe. Number two, science has affected the opinions of the people of the world. Then J.B.S. Haldane talks about scientific point of view and legal point of view. The writer says that legal point of view is one thing and scientific point of view is quite another thing. He makes it very clear, stating that a judge is very neutral in delivering his judgment between two individuals. A judge does not take side of either of the parties. He maintains neutrality in delivering his verdict or judgment. But a scientist is not only impartial between people, but also about a tapeworm and solar system. A scientist says what a tapeworm is and what the solar system is. A scientist states it impartially. Next, the writer talks about issues between Negroes and white men. The inclination of the average man always dwelt on emotional and ethical side of the issue rather than on facts. For this, Haldane gives example regarding the problems of the American Negroes. Some Americans believe that Negroes are inferior to them and they should be segregated from them, while some believe that they should enjoy the same right and duties like white Americans. But the scientist says that both these people or both the groups of people are comfortable only in their respectable areas, in their respective areas, and both of them die whenever they set they step into each other's areas, regions. The next point that J.B.S. Haldane discusses in his essay is sin punishment disease. Haldane says that our approach to the problem of disease is not rational. He says that the pre-Christians believe that if someone was suffering from any disease, they feel that it was a punishment of some god or goddess. Haldane makes it clear that health and sickness and diseases are part of nature, not a result of sin or punishment or curse of any god or goddess. J.B.S. Haldane then talks about lack of scientific temperament, scientific spirit among the people. He says that prevention is better than cure. He says that people all over the world lack scientific temperament, scientific spirit. When they become sick, they do not think it rationally or scientifically. Haldane makes it clear with a very common example. He says that diabetes can be cured by taking insulin regularly, but people ignore it. Typhoid, diphtheria, smallpox, and measles are the diseases that can be cured if medicines are taken regularly. Airborne diseases too can be prevented by public effort, but most of the people do not care to follow the scientific temperament, scientific rules, medicines prescribed by the physicians or the surgeons. Haldane says that the common people always try to cure from their beliefs, but scientific from their beliefs, but scientific attempts to prevent the disease. Hence, people lack scientific temperament or a spirit, and they suffer from different diseases. Conclusion. Last but not least, J.B.S. Haldane says that people should have scientific point of view, scientific stand, because scientific stand is God's eye view, the most correct view, the most correct stand. Until and unless people adopt the scientific point of view, the enemies of science cannot be conquered or defeated. To conclude, the scientific point of view is a very interesting essay. Students must study this essay, and they should have scientific spirit, that they should inculcate and develop scientific spirit in the issues of life, in the problems of life. Thanks for